heaven here today to honor the life of Father Sylvester Mason. I just want to, before we pray, I just want to tell you that Father Sue is a friend of a lot of people here. And she's been a mother, a grandmother. She's been a dear friend of mine. She has been a dear friend of mine. Father Sue and I are very good friends. We've been through a lot of things throughout a number of years. But I love that woman. She's a great friend. She's made around the world. Praise God. She told me she was going there. And I can only believe what she tells me. So I'm not too jealous. And I tell you, I've never known anyone that loved inspirational music any better than she did. Especially the inspiration. I think she could have followed them all over the world if she had the resources. And she knew them by name, and they knew her. She would go to these concerts, and she sat right there in the front row. And she would talk to them, and they would talk to her. She was a wonderful woman. She loved good Christian music. She loved Christian music. So let's pray. Let's pray. Father in heaven, You have blessed us. You have blessed us with the opportunity and the blessings, Father, of knowing Barbara. Lord, we have experienced a life, Father, of many years of knowing her, and family have known her all their lives. So, Father, we thank you. We thank you today. We thank you for that knowledge. We thank you for that experience, Lord. There have been rough times, but Lord, we don't care about those. We just think about the good times and the smiles and the laughter. Lord, we thank you for that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the family that we share. Thank you, Lord, for the time we're going to have today. We're going to listen to some songs and we're going to We're going to love you today, Lord. This Barbara's done, she's done, made her decisions. Today, we're going to love you. Thank you, God. Thank you for bringing us together today, Father, on this momentous occasion. Thank you, dear God. Pray these things in your blessing. Amen. Like this. Look at the obituary today. Barbara Sue Richardson Mason, 74 years old. Junction City died February the 3rd, 2023, at the Danville Center of Health Rehabilitation. She was born in Danville, March 23rd, 1948. She was a very young woman. 1948, daughter of the late William Henry and Margaret Leola Wilson Richardson. She was a homemaker, and her faith was part of her strength. She was a member of Jefferson City Wesleyan Church. Barbara enjoyed gathering her family and her friends for potluck luncheons. Her cat, Kitty Baker, was precious to her as was her love for the harmonious gospel quartet. The inspirations. Most importantly to Barbara was the love she had for her family. Barbara was preceded in death by her parents, her son Christopher Herring, and her daughter Gala Sarah. Simpson, Heather Simpson, Savannah Hodge, Matthew Simpson, and 20 great-grandchildren that I don't have to read. And that's all of the obituary that I have.
Anybody just make any kind of donations to help pay for it? wife's got a letter that Matt Cassidy wrote. I think she's gonna read that.
Beyond mortal human.
Martha then said, said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. Even then, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. And Jesus said to her, your brother will arise, will rise again. And Martha said to him, I know that he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. But Jesus said to her, he says, I am the resurrection and the life. And whoever believes in me will live again, even if he dies. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? This is the message for us. This is the message for Margaret that she and I talked about for many, many, many days. And she told me she believed. And if she believed, as she told me that the Bible tells me right here that she will live again. If that is true, she's in the arms of Jesus now. That's just a body here. That's just a body. She's in the arms of our Almighty Savior now. We can rejoice. We can rejoice in this. She has made it where you and I haven't gotten yet. We still have to go. We still have to deal with this, what's left in this life that we have to make it through. We have to still deal with the sickness and the pain and the agony and the fighting and the stuff that's still in front of us. It's over. But it's done. If you believe, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. She stops breathing, but she lives now with Christ. You must believe this, children. You must believe this. It's not something that should go in one ear and out the other. You've got to believe this and let this be a part of your everyday living and thinking and thought. It's something that's got to be a part of your everyday thinking and walking and talking. But you've got to live the life. I'm afraid that too many people today are believing that everybody's going to heaven. That is not true. In the Gospel of Matthew, he says, enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate that leads to destruction. And broad is the way that leads to destruction. And there are many who enter that way. Broad is the gate that leads to destruction, and many that enter that way. And I'm preaching to everybody. Listen, broad is the way, and many that enter that. Most people will go by the way of the broad gate. Enter through the narrow gate. He says, enter through the narrow gate, for the gate is small and the way is narrow that leads to life. That leads to life. And there are few who find it. I'm preaching to the ones that are alive. That we can make the change today in our lives. We can make the change to our lives today. She told me she made the change. And I can rejoice. It's easy for me to preach a funeral when someone has made the change. I can rejoice in that. I can rejoice. Someday, I'm going to be in that, by the way, that's a great casket. Someday I'm going to be in there. I'm going to heaven, and that's my choice. It's not a chance, it's a choice. I can choose to go to hell, but I'm not. And I don't want you to either. You know, listen, it's not because Aiden wants to go to heaven. If you want to, because that's just the thing everybody's doing. You must walk. You must walk the talk. You can't talk the walk. You've got to walk the talk. You've got to walk the talk. You've got to walk the talk. There's something the Lord tells us in Matthew that, Lord, Lord, we preached your name on the streets. We talked about you on the streets. We talked your name. We walked your name. We talked about you everywhere we went. He says, you know what he says? Depart from me. I never knew you. You spoke my name. I didn't know you. He said, we've got to get serious about this. We've got to get serious. We've got to pray. This is 17,000 people died 2 days ago. Were they ready? Most of them probably were not. Over in Turkey. Every person in this world has a day appointed for their death before they were ever born. Your day is appointed for your death before you were ever born. Marcia's day is appointed before she was ever born. My day is appointed. I don't know if it is a bad or not, but it's appointed for me to die before I was ever born. It's in Psalm 139. Read it. It's there. Every person is appointed. We grant it. We don't come ready to it. And we can get ready. God will help us. I want to close with the devotion here. Beautiful devotion. I hear the sound, by the way, Matthew, and you and your friend, and I think this is, you all have done a magnificent job. I applaud you all, and you all have done a great job with what you've done here. Went forth and dug the grave and all the effort you put forward. I salute you. And it is just an amazing job. I hear the sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet as Gabriel sounds the call. At the midnight cry, we'll be going home. When Jesus steps out on a cloud and calls God's children, the dead in Christ shall rise to meet him in the air, and then those that remain will be quickly changed at the midnight cry when Jesus comes again. I look around me, and the prophecies fulfilling, and the signs of times there appearing everywhere, and I can almost hear the Father as he says, Son, go get my children. At the midnight cry, the bride of Christ shall rise. When Jesus steps out on the cloud and calls God's children, come home. We are God's children. Praise God.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ. It's all the things we ask in His presence.